Welcome to I Know a Guy Bicycles, hanging out with a guy series. Hi, I'm Justin the Guy, taking the scary out of you's one bike at a time. So, hey, working on this bike and got the drivetrain cleaned up the frame, the wheels are true, everything is beautiful, until I realized, and this is just an oversight of me not picking up on everything, not the chain speed crankset on a 9-speed drivetrain with 9-speed shifters. So, no wonder it wasn't shifting very well up front, because a 10-speed drivetrain takes a narrower chain, so the gapping between the big cog and the small cog is too tight, and where you have chain from like small to small, it's gonna rub against that chain ring. Plus, wherever I had this bike before, switched this to more of a compact, which this is a 50 with a 34 or something like that. So luckily I have some extra parts. So I have the same length crank arm, but the same vintage, which matches this Ultegra, two chain ring 175s with the bottom bracket. So you're gonna watch me tear this off and throw on the new one. So first, what we need to do is take the chain off by just pulling the derailleur down. Not completely off, just in the point where we can get to it. Put the bike up in a vertical position for me to actually see it. And what we need to do is release the two bolts that are on the left crank arm. So, yeah, I'm surprised I didn't notice that right off the bat. It's one of those things where I should have. just didn't occur to me. Just kind of moving right along. Take the adjuster cap off. Release the safety pin or installing pin. Then take the crank off. So that's the 10-speed crank. Now I need to remove the bottom bracket. These have external bearings. So the same concept as forward pedaling for the pedals, taking them off, same thing for the bearings. One's gonna be reverse thread and one is the positive thread. Give it a little tap so I can get it started to loosen up. Sometimes my brackets get pretty tight in there. And I gotta move my tool to avoid bumping into the derailleur. Forward to loosen and backwards. There'll be a mark on these external cups. Let's say tighten with the tighten arrow. So that's how that works. Other side, same thing. Tap it so it breaks loose. Sometimes these get really tight. You know, that's a really cheaters. I'm just fortunate on this one. So, and if, you know, one will have an R on it, one will have an L, so you'll know right and left. So I got the right and left bearings here. R and L. Somewhere on there. Anyway, so, and it has a little protective sleeve that just prevents contaminants from drainage from the seat tube or whatever, or water composure. It doesn't get into the spindle, protects the spindle here. So that's the bottom bracket removal. While I have this apart, I usually like to clean up the inside a little bit. If it gets a little dirty in there, it's always good to have clean threads. That kind of thing. And the weirdest thing I found on the bottom bracket was a dead bee. So things get in there, which kind of throws me off a little bit once in a while. So here is 38 shell, also a shell for road bikes, most of the time are 38 millimeters, which is the width across it. Mountain bikes sometimes get to 72 or 73. And then there's Italian threads you gotta watch out for too. So there's kind of a little bit of different mix of parts out there. That you have to worry about making sure it's the right size and thread pitch. But lucky for me, I have the right stuff. So I put a little bit of grease on these so they don't get seized in there, because you're in the bottom bracket area where a lot of contaminants do get kicked up, and that can really damage the bottom bracket. And this guy is fortunately pretty smooth. Don't need my hammer. And like pedals, pedaling backwards or spinning it backwards towards the rear of the bike tightens. The idea that it won't loosen up on you while you're pedaling. That's the reason why this is very stiff for some reason. External bearings. And I have is the thread, so apparently I'm tightening it up against some. And you want it to go all the way flush to the frame. We got something going on here that's unique. Oh. I just wonder if the strings. Well, no, I didn't cross thread it in here. What is going on? So yeah, I come across something funky here. So I gotta get the brace on this so it doesn't back out. So I have this little cheater piece that's in there. It holds this mechanism in place. Now let me give it a try on this side. Huh. Somewhere along the lines it got oddly stiff. Anywho, I think what it was is I loosened up the screw that screws into the cable guides underneath, and that was sticking out far enough. I was bumping the bottom bracket cartridge up enough that I wasn't able to get it in there straight. So the non-dry side cup would not engage. There we go. So I screw that back in. We'll see if it bumps up against it, or there's a little concave. Yeah, there's a concave part. So to show what happened, this is the bottom bracket I'm putting in there, similar to it. Well, it has this little lip which is going through, which actually is going through this direction. And that screw that holds the cable guide must have just moved it just a little bit so I can kind of get the cup side to fit in there tight. So, but it's over now and everything is smooth. So once that installed, I like to put in a little bit of grease on these threads. So it engages the teeth on the inside a little bit better. And these are sometimes a little tricky, so my trick is where the vertical of the chainring is, I'll look on the other side. Once I get it to start threading. As they'll bump up against those teeth. My chain keeps on wanting to get in the way. Get that out of the way. There we go. So they'll line up those teeth, and it's kind of, I'm talking about soft alloy crank arm versus hardened steel. Which is a 52. I'm gonna make sure that's out of the way. There we go. Turn that back up. So the derailleur's out of the way. We just wanna tighten this up so it doesn't bump up against the chainring. The love crank arm. Line it up with the other side. Kind of softly feel those teeth engage. Make sure they're not pressing on top of them. On there, and then double check, make sure my derailleur is flush with the chain rings. Tighten the cable down. Adjustments, but I want to make sure he's unpedaling this. Mm-hmm. There we go. There's a lot right there. Like how it's supposed to. Voila! Now, componentry all matches. This guy will either be back stock or I'll end up selling it or whatever. But that's why I have extra parts. I buy them in kind of when I can get a chance, or if I have to break down a frame, I keep some of them aside. So situations like this. And luckily for me, since I'm working in the same kind of vintage, mid-2000s, or mid-teens, you know, the componentry in that mix, I've been kind of like getting back stock of those things. So I kind of have a lot of those things as like spare parts, extra cranksets sometimes. So in this case, I lucked out. I didn't have to go out and buy a set. But there is people out there like myself that do sell the extra parts, and I've had to buy it from them before if I was, you know, missing a shifter or something like that, or gone bad and needed, or brakes or something like that. You can buy them individually. Yeah, you pay a little price for them, but hey, you get the same vintage and you're not kind of smashing up really new componentry with older componentry. And if it's, you know, still in good shape and works well, why not match it with the period that it was actually made? So there you go. I'll just do some fine tuning on this and wrap the bars, and another bike is ready to go out. Thank you for spending time with me. Here's the shameless plug. If you like these videos, hit subscribe. If you're on my Facebook page, you see this, like my Facebook page. You also can go to my website, iknowaguybicycles.com. Throw down your email to join the email list. I appreciate all that. And thank you for spending your time with me. And until next time, thank you very much. Have a great day.